Good morning, student. Today I am going to start a new chapter of your English literature book for standard 4, and the topic of the chapter is the missing shoes. Now see here, student, this is the topic of the chapter, the missing shoes. It is first chapter of your literature book, the missing shoes. Now I am going to read this chapter and I will make you understand this chapter according to the paragraph wise. Now student, I just want to give you the introduction of this chapter. What is the main introduction of this chapter? What is the chapter based on? Student, this chapter is based on a girl. As the introduction of this chapter is, in this chapter we will read about a girl whose name was Ela. Actually the main character in this chapter is Ela, the girl whose name was Ela. Ela was an untidy girl. Now see the word untidy. Now untidy means, student, messy. A person or a student or a child who is untidy, it's known as messy or untidy. Now Ela was an untidy girl who always used to throw her things and her belongings here and there. She never used to clean her room or her toys. Student, in which room you live, you must need to clean it every day and keep your belongings in its proper place. Never used to keep her things in its proper place. She never used to clean her house or her room, or never used to keep her things in proper place. Now this was the introduction of the chapter. That means in this chapter we will read about a girl who was very untidy and never used to keep her things in its proper place. Now every day Ela's parents told her to clean her bedroom, and every day she ignored them. It was a real mess. Now see, every day her parents used to tell her that Ela, please clean your room, please clean your toys or keep your things in proper place. But every time that girl used to deny for their work, denied for her work to do, or she used to postpone her works. That means she will do after some time or tomorrow or day after tomorrow. She always used to postpone her work to do later on. She could hardly open the door because there were so many toys, dirty clothes and books lying on the carpet. It was too difficult to even to open the door also, because there were lots many things were kept in front of the door. Many things were thrown here and there. So it was quite difficult for someone or for her also to open her door very clearly. One morning, as Ela was lying on her bed, her mother stuck her head in the door and said, Ela, look at this mess. You need to clean your room. We are taking Rohan to the zoo today. Clean your room. We are leaving after lunch. Now, one morning, her mother told Ela that while she was lying, means that means that while the girl was sleeping on her bed, her mother stuck her head in the door. That means ki when her mother was going into Ela's room, she stuck her head. That means ki stucking her head, yani ki bang karna, kisi cheez se bang karna, stuck karna, hit karna. She stuck her head on the door of Ela's room. Now and she said her, that means she gave the information to Ela that they have planned that they will go to the zoo. That means Ela's mother, father, Ela and her brother with her granny, they all will go to the zoo. They all have planned that they all will go to the zoo after some time. Ela looked at the mess on her floor. It's too messy. Now see. So she herself looked at into her room. Are wow, so dirty. All the things were thrown here and there. It was too messy. All the dirty things were thrown here and there. And it was quite difficult to select something or to take something or to find out something from her room. I don't know where to start. She herself saying, student. Now see there what she herself saying. I don't know where to start. That means this girl was herself confused. This girl was herself confused ki where to start to clean my room. I will just leave it and clean it after we get home from you, she said. Now I am reading this sentence once more. Please listen carefully. Ela looked at the mess on the floor. It's too messy. I don't know where to start. I will just leave it and clean it after we get home from the zoo, she said. Now see, I have already told you that she had the habit of postponing her things. That means she kal karenge, baad mein karenge, aur kuch der baad kar lenge. She has the habit of postponing her things. So see what said? She said that I will clean it when I will return back from the zoo. That means she already had planned that when she will return back from the zoo, she will clean her house. Now she is not going to clean it. Ela, it's time for lunch, her mother called. Ela ran into the kitchen. What are we having today, mom? She asked. Puri, aloo and kheer. Wow, delicious food. Now see, puri, garam garam. Aloo, very spicy. And kheer, it's so delicious and tasty. Na, this whole things are very delicious and tasty, na? Can you smell the kheer? Her mother answered. Now see, her mother is asking to Ela here. That Ela asked her mother, what are the things made today for lunch? Then her mother said, puri, aloo and kheer. Now can you smell the kheer? Her mother answered, it smells delicious. Delicious means tasty. Very tasty. Delicious means it is very tasty. Can we take some old breads to feed the animals? Now that Rohan will enjoy watching us feed them, Ela said. Rohan was sitting in his chair looking around the room. Now I am reading it once more. It smelled delicious. Can we take some old bread to zoo to feed the animals? Now the Rohan will enjoy watching us feed them, said Ela. Rohan was sitting in his chair looking around the room. Now this was the conversation between Ela and her mother, that Ela was discussing with her mother that she wants to take some bread, some old breads from the bakery to feed the animals in the zoo. And it is good also, student, to feed the animals. It is good to feed the animals, to show your sympathy towards the animals, to show your kindness towards the animals. It is good. If you have something extra or something useless which you don't eat, you can just feed that thing to the animals. It is our duty to protect the animals also, or to save the animals also. We will stop by the bakery and pick some old breads up if you would like. Now hurry and eat and then we will go. It's going to be a lovely day. Granny is coming with us. She will be here any minute, mother said. Now these are all the words or the sentences said by the mother. She is telling that you just eat your lunch and after that when the granny will come, we all will go to the zoo. Go and get your shoes on and then we will go. Now see this statement. Go and get your shoes and then we will go. Now go and get your shoes. How that girl will get her shoes? Now just think for a while. As her room was too messy, it was quite difficult for her to find the things where she has kept, because none of her things was kept in its proper place. So it is quite difficult for her here to find her shoes. But her mother has ordered her to go and find your shoes. Now, Ela ate her lunch and then ran into her room to get her shoes after eating aloo, puri and kheer. She ate the lunch. That means she had her lunch, aloo, puri and kheer. And then her mother ordered her that go and get your shoes. She just rushed to her room. She just ran to her room to get her shoes. But there was a problem. She could only find one of them. See, shoes is in pair. Na, do hoga, tabhi to joote dono pair mein hum pehnenge. But problem kya hui Ela ke saath? Due to her untidiness, she was able to find only one of the shoes from that pair. She could only find one of them. She looked under her bed but could only see the dirty towels and pants. She moved some of her toys out of the way but still could find her shoes. Now see, that girl was in very rush. She was in hurry to go to the zoo. So she went through her room and tried to find all the things here and there. She tried herself to find her shoes, but she was disabled. She was not able to find her shoes. And that time what she did? She just threw whatever the things were thrown here and there. She just tried to find out her shoes from that mass. After she had checked everywhere she could in her room, she ran into the kitchen. Hi granny. Now when again after getting the shoes, she did not get the shoes and then she rushed to the kitchen. Then she saw there her granny already had arrived. She said hi to granny. She called to her grandma who had just arrived. "Mom, I can't find my shoe. Will you wait while I look for it?" she asked. Now she is asking for her mother's problem. Now see this child. She wants some more time to find her shoes. And so she is asking for her mother's permission to wait for a while. I'll find my shoes and then we all will go to the zoo. Now student, till here I have taught you in first part of the video. This is the first part of the video in which I have taught you about the Ela's behavior and her habit of postponing things to do her work tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Now in my next video, I will teach you the remaining part of this chapter. Till now your homework is student, just look it very carefully. Here this is your homework of this chapter. Now see what you all have to do student. You have to write the synonyms of all these words, then antonyms of all these words, and then you have to write the Hindi meaning of this word, and also you have to frame the sentences from this word. Understood? That means ki synonyms. Here are the 5 words. You have to write its synonyms. And after that, antonyms. After writing the synonyms and antonyms, you have to write the Hindi meaning of these words. And after that, student, you have to frame sentences from these words. That means ki these 5 words are here, given here, na? From these words, you have to frame the sentences also. Understood? Till then, stay safe, stay home, goodbye. And in my next video, I will teach you the remaining part of this chapter.